Green-lipped mussels, spare ribs, venison, king salmon. It's enough to make any foodie salivate.
Great time to be a dog, eh? They've got a pretty good, you know, if you went to a restaurant and ordered all that, you'd be looking pretty expensive meal.
But all this is being heralded as the future of our pet's tucker.
Getting back to basics, more natural, no fillers, no additives, no preservatives.
Sometimes I look at the packets or the cans of cat food at the supermarket and they sound like gourmet dinners.
As people become more savvy about what's on their plate, there's growing interest in premium pet food.
They're picking up the pack, they're looking at the back of it, they want to make sure that they're seeing really good quality ingredients going in there and they want to know the story behind it.
Some owners taking the responsibility further than others.
They're over in Hong Kong, they come up and they'll sniff it, they'll taste it, they'll give it to their friends, and if they're into it, they'll give it to their pets.
So if pet owners are putting their money where their mouth is, it only makes sense that I do. Here's some New Zealand ocean salmon. And despite the price, it's not actually that bad.
It's a sweeter taste for the businesses, though.
It's huge now. North America alone, $65 billion a year on pet food. New Zealand retail and the supermarkets, about $380 million.
New Zealand pet food manufacturers are eager to claim a share.
New Zealand has got that really good reputation for organic, free-range, grass-fed beef, grass-fed lamb. They like to know that their pets are getting the best meat that they can.
A trend that'll mean man's best friend getting the very best man has to offer. Sam Clarke, One News.